Hi everyone, I'm Christina, and in this video, we'll talk about anti-ransomware protection in Windows 10 with Defender Antivirus. Very quickly, before we begin, let's see what this is, how to set it up, and what are some common use cases. In this section of Defender settings, we have ransomware protection. Then select Manage, and then Controlled Folder Access. This feature, as it says here in its description, will protect files, folders, and also memory areas from unauthorized changes. The description is a bit vague, made by design. In practice, applications will be denied access to sensitive folders, like users, documents, and others. We can add folders to be protected and also the applications which are allowed to write there. So far, so good. Let's make a few attempts and see if this protection is effective. First example, I have this PowerShell script that simply tries to create a file in the documents folder. It will fail to open the file, and there will be also a warning message that PowerShell application was prevented to make changes here. A very similar thing will happen with Python scripts. When running the script, again it won't be able to open the file for writing because the folder is protected. Lastly, I have an autoeat script that also writes something, and I will compile it to an exe file, then run it. There is a 10 seconds delay until the first message box. So there was an error and no file was created. Also, a friendly pop-up message from Defender Antivirus. That's great. We cannot just simply write to a protected folder. Let's see what research exists regarding this neat Defender feature. This paper, for example, presents three bypass methods: APC injection, which is a type of process injection, WMI, tricks, and Office macros. All three techniques are detailed in the paper. This blog post shows another interesting method that uses OLLI objects to drive Office executables programmatically from VB scripts. This last technique is very similar with the Office macros trick because one can use a VB script to call Office, the Word application, and then instruct it to create files. In this video, I want to present a new technique which relies on mimicking behavior of legitimate editors, process hallowing, and a few process spoofing tricks. I've noticed something interesting when I run this autoeat script from the site editor itself. After the 10 seconds delay, it will actually create a file in the protected folder without being blocked by the Defender AV. If you're wondering, this behavior is not dependent on the delay. I'll comment the sleep instruction and rerun it to make sure the file is still created. So a file got created. Fine. This is in a way expected because Site is a text editor and it makes sense that Windows probably decided to allow it to create text files in the documents folder. We'll see how we can mimic this from another process without actually having to depend on the site editor. I will use this process hollowing technique I've presented in a previous video, but add a few twists to simulate an actual site editor. First, the host process used for hollowing will be the site editor, which I've seen that it's allowed by Windows Defender. I'll also pass a correct parameter when spawning the process to look like the actual editor editing an actual file. Finally, very important, I will pass a PID of a parent process to be used as a fake parent for our application. We'll see in a minute how to practically do this. To fake the parent process, I'll use a known trick, which I've actually discussed in a previous video. It relies on the parent process attributes created here. You can check this out later. Alright, we don't need AutoEat for now. I have already compiled the source code you've seen before on a Windows 7 virtual machine. I have two applications. First one is the payload named Hello World, which will try to edit or modify a file in a protected folder. Then the actual executable that does the hollowing and fake parent trick. Copy both of the files to this Windows 10 VM from a shared folder. If I run the payload first by itself, it won't be able to modify files in the protected folder. It means that Windows correctly prevented this binary from making changes. Nice. Next, we'll inject this same payload binary using process hollowing into site text editor. This will allow it to work undetected. To do that, I'll start the application from the command line. We need to supply a process ID to be used as fake parent. Let's use this PID of explorer.exe because this is the actual legitimate parent of site editor in any common scenario. Its PID is 50060. I've added a sleep instruction before modifying the file to be able to check the process in Process Explorer while running. A file was written, and the process responsible for this looks like the site editor. Check its path here. That's process hollowing in action. The command line also has a hello.txt file as argument, and the parent of this process is explorer.exe. All this information is fake. This was not spawned from explorer.exe, it was actually created from another process that spoofed its parent. This is pretty interesting. Let's delete the text file and try the technique again. Great! So we've seen that we can very easily write to this folder using a few simple tricks. We have simulated launching a legitimate text editor, having a text file as parameter with the expected parent process, explorer.exe. In this case, it's very difficult for Windows to distinguish between real editing activity and process hollowing, simulating the editor. To be clear, this is not a vulnerability in Windows Defender. Also, process hollowing and the tricks to spoof parent process have been around for a long time. If you're curious about this topic, check the other research papers mentioned in the beginning. If you like this video, please support the channel by subscribing. Thank you!